thank you so much for taking the time to hear the powerful word of truth from Prophet Bishop H. Walker. By way of special announcements, join Prophet Walker at True Life Pentecost Church every second Sunday of each month in Atlanta, Georgia at 957 Metropolitan Parkway at 4:30 p.m. Also join in with True Light every fourth Sunday of each month in Charlotte, North Carolina at 300 North Tryon Street, located at the Public Library of Charlotte. For further details, go to www.truelightpentecost.org and click on announcements for any current events. Thank you so much for supporting Prophet Walker and the True Light Ministry. Be encouraged and be blessed. You are now viewing Prophet H. Walker and True Light Pentecost Church. Those that are viewing and seeking after righteousness, repent and be baptized, every one of you, in the name of Jesus Christ, for the remission of sins, and ye shall receive the gift of the Holy Ghost.
Time to verse 6. Let no man deceive you with vain words, because of these things cometh the wrath of God from the children of disobedience. And anytime a soul is not obedient, you know, anytime you're not saved, God is not happy with you. You know, God, he hates it. You know, God frowns out.
Oh, sinner. Oh, sinner. Oh,
sinner man, you know that you some wonderful praise reports here. Our daughter Bianca, 6 pieces of gold.
Yeah.
Our daughter Jane, 16 adults.
Yeah.
Ms. Jacob Galantine, 5 pieces of gold.
Man.
Jacob Galantine, $10. Yeah. Mr. Kenya, $50.
Yeah.
Elder Lansing right back. $440.
Yeah.
Yeah. Yeah. Mr. King again, you're having $250.
Yeah.
And I'm here again, $225.
Yeah.
Daughter Samaya, right back after last week, $200.
Yeah.
Senator Brooks, after a big contribution last week, right back,
$420.
Yeah. Elder Big Man Rose, last week, right back, $400. I report our leaders for the month. Evangelist Wagner. Big work. Jumping up into second place in a big way. Elder Lansing Smith.
Yeah, yeah.
First place, kind of close. Senior Elder Brooks. And Elder Richard Smith.
Yeah.
Senior Elder Brooks just noted him out. And thank God for all spirit of not allowing the fleshly things of this life to be of any value.
Amen.
To the True Life family.
Yeah.
We are truly walking by faith and not by sight. We are truly putting the oracles of God ahead of any material advantage or material gain. We thank God again that we have been singled out.
Amen.
And we're trying to debate right now, so in the news, and they're saying, the presidential candidate for the Republican Party stated that Obama was a Muslim.
Amen.
And man, they just got all upset. He shouldn't have said that. He shouldn't have said that. If he's a Muslim, it's all right to be president. And I wish they had called me.
All right. Glory. Hallelujah.
America never was so kind of Obama.
That's right, Bob. Glory.
America was founded on the Christian faith.
Yeah.
So much so they drove the Puritans from England because they worshiped one God.
Amen.
And his
Amen.
Name was Jesus.
That's right.
He said, we can't have this man. You're saying to that, they call it the new world.
Yeah.
Hallelujah.
Yes.
But God had a plan for that Jesus only church.
Yeah.
To be a foundation right here and not Islam.
That's right.
And I don't care what you worship. That's what it is. But I'm going to say that you can bring America and make America an Islamic state.
That's right. Lord, hallelujah.
And two can't walk together except religion.
Yeah,
Lord. Even the Holy Spirit is Christian. There's no such thing as we are both Christian and Muslim at the same time.
Come on,
Father.
Hallelujah.
And God ordained it so, so that we could have a liberty to be the guiding light, so that the whole world, if they choose, can come into Christianity. But God had to have a headquarters that all nations could come. According to Isaiah, the 2nd chapter.
Amen.
All nations could flee to.
Yeah.
And that nation is America.
Yeah.
And that's why God blessed America. Not because America was so right.
Yeah.
America that probably never was right. But at least America allowed the Christian faith to be the center of gravity of the religious movement right here.
Amen.
In America. All nations began to flow through. Well, this is what it's like this.
Amen. Right.
Amen. Well, I got some emails the other night, but I think I read them off. Now, if I did call your name, raise your hand. I think we got just about everybody.
Amen.
All right, again, we're so thankful for that as far as time.
Situation that is in today, because America's not trusted in God. You know, anytime you're not trusting in the God, you know, you serve an adversary.
Yeah.
You know, and anytime you serve an adversary, you know, you in a losing battle. You can't win. You know, because
yeah.
The adversary, his whole mission, and people fail to realize that the adversary's whole mission is to kill, steal, and take you to the lake of fire.
Amen.
You know, that's his whole mission. The adversary ain't trying to help you. You know, the adversary, I would say, he was in heaven. That's the ultimate goal for humanity, you know, to make it to heaven. He was dead. He wanted to overtake God. And got kicked out, you know. So his only joy is to try to take every soul to the lake of fire with him. But I thank God he ain't taking true life. You know, might take the world, but he's not taking life, you know. And it's so sad that, you know, we're in a day and time that, you know, like the Bible says, people love to have a soul, you know, love to be lied to, love to be in sin, you know. But I thank God that he brought us out of sin.
Right.
He brought us out of darkness into his marvelous light. And I got a couple of scriptures I want to go to real quickly in Ephesians, the 5th chapter. And I'll pick up at verse 3 and it reads, but fornication and all uncleanness or covetousness is, let it not be once named among you as becoming saints. You know, and we know the sodomites and lesbians wouldn't want to read nothing like this.
Amen.
And, you know, we stated it time and time again. If God condemned condemned fornication, what do you think about sodomy and lesbianism? What do you think about that, you know? But people, you know, are so, like the Bible says, so foolish in that imagination, you know, and hate God so much, you know. It's one thing to you know, not be saved, but it's another thing to just let the adversary make a complete idiot out of you. You know, anytime a man have a desire for another man, you know, that's sickness, you know. Your mind all messed up, you know. That's why the Bible says be renewed in the spirit of your mind, you know. Let this mind be in you that's in Christ Jesus. You got to think like Jesus wants you to think.
Amen.
You know, we all, some of us, you know, well, none of us born saved, but I ain't never looked at another man and had a desire. I can't remember I did all kind of stuff before I got saved, but I ain't never looked at another boy and had lust, you know. But, you know, that's what the adversary do. He'll make a fool out of you if you let him. And I'm going to jump down to verse 6. Let no man deceive you with vain words, because of these things cometh the wrath of God upon the children of disobedience. And anytime a soul is not obedient, you know, anytime you're not saved, God is not happy with you. You know, God, he hates sin. You know, God frowned down at sin.
Yes.
But God is a merciful God. He will give everybody a space to repent. But it's up to you when God give you that space and send you that word, it's up to you to do something. And verse 7, be not therefore partakers with them, for we were sometimes darkness, but now are ye in the light, in the Lord. Walk as children of the light.
Amen.
And verse 9, for the fruit of the Spirit is in all goodness and righteousness and truth. And verse 10, proving what is acceptable unto the Lord. And verse 11, and have no fellowship with the unfruitful works of darkness, but rather reprove them. And that's why every time we get a chance, you know, to tell somebody that's not saved, you got to repent and be baptized in Jesus' name. You got to come into holiness if you want to be saved. You
Amen.
Know? It's one thing, like I said, to not be saved, but it's another thing to stay, you know, in that condition, you know. And just like I was sharing with a co-worker
Amen.
On a job, you know, that, you know, when Jesus rose from the grave, the Bible said he rose with all power on earth and in heaven was in his hand.
Yeah.
Right.
But because of the people's unbelief, you know, because of, you know, people didn't want to accept Jesus as their Savior, a certain amount of Satan's power was restored to him, you know, because of people allowed it to them. Just like when he was in Nazareth, the Bible said he could do, you know, a great thing because of the people's unbelief, you
yeah.
know. And that's why in the true church, we can't have no unbelief, you know, whatsoever. You know, anything that's of, like the Bible says, anything that's not of faith is of sin. You
yeah.
know, you got to rebuke that immediately. Don't
yeah.
never let the adversary play games on your mind, you know. We got a great prophet, we got a great church, you know. And if a person come in the side of Mike, you don't stay no side of Mike. You get delivered from that. You hurry up, like the prophet. When I came, he told me, you ought to run up here, you know.
Yeah.
And that's what them side of Mike's ought to do. They ought to hurry up and run and get water baptized in Jesus' name, you know. Because that's a, you know, that's a gross, you know. And Kim Davis, you know, look like she's trying to stretch straddle, but you can't stretch. You can't fence straddle serving the Lord. You on the lower side or you're not. You're on the lower side, you gotta stand up and put
Amen.
Them hip boots on and put them battle shoes on and battle. Tell that devil you a lie in Jesus' name.
Amen.
Like Prophet said, if you wanna throw the key away forever, you know,
Amen.
And send me to jail. You got to stand up for what is truth. You gotta stand up for what is right, you know. Just like the Hebrew boys, you know. When they were thrown in a fiery furnace, you know. They said, oh, king, live forever, you know.
Amen.
We know you're the king, but we're not going to turn our back on the Lord, you know.
Amen.
So you might as well go ahead, turn that fire up, you know, because we're not going to bow. And that's what it's all about, you know. Never bow down to the adversary, you know. Never bow a compromise with the adversary, because that's what they want you to do. As soon as you compromise, as soon as you bow down, they're going to be like, I told you so.
Right.
You know, but I thank God that they don't have that on true light. We stand up for the truth. Preach the word, be instant in season, out of season, whether they like it or whether they don't like it.
Yeah.
The word of God, a preacher's job is to always preach God's word. And not only preach, you got to stand by it.
Amen.
You got to live it, you know. Preaching is one thing, you know, but living it is something else. I believe Jeremiah say, it's when I got applied, it's a little bit bitter. know. But I thank God, he said it's like fire in my bones. Don't want to do it, but I got to do it. You know, and that's how we have to be. We have to, you know, preach God's word. We got to stand on it because that's the only thing we have. We don't have nothing in this world, you know. Mama, daddy, sister, brother, you know. And look at, you know, some, like me and some of the priests, what we're going through. Whole families, you know, have turned their back on us. But like the Bible said, if God be for you, who can be against you?
That's right.
You know? If God on your side, you got everything you need. You know, not only God on your side, true light on your side.
Amen.
You know, you got blessings, many blessings. So, you know, I think about it on a daily basis, you know. Elder Kevin, Elder Marshall, thank God. Minister Kenya, baby, here we got the victory. Total victory. More babies coming, more marriages, you know, more churches. That church was whatever we desire in our heart, God gonna give us, you know. We claim Charlotte and God gonna give us an edifice in Charlotte.
Amen.
If it's only a church deal, you know, whatever God wills for us to have, he gonna give it to us, you know. And never looking at things in the natural, you know. Natural, because when the adversary gets you in the natural, he got you, you know. You always gotta look at from a spiritual standpoint. If God promised me, something, he gonna give it to me, you know? And that's why, you know praying, you know, and fasting and coming to church Monday, Wednesday, Friday, twice on Sunday is so important, because to keep that battery charged and to keep you looking at things in a spiritual standpoint. Going on the job and going around all these dangers and even on your phone on the internet and television, you know, that stuff is, oh my goodness, it's like, you know, battery draining. You know, it drains the spirit, you know, because of so much calamity on the world, so much destruction, you know. And I thank God when we come to church, we get that battery charged right up.
Amen.
You know, keep praying, you know, and keep fasting. And I'm going to go to my closing scripture in the book of Jude, you know, because we got to fight. You know, we're in a damn time and we can't sit down in our church. We got to do a whole lot of fighting. Book of Jude. The third verse, it said, "Beloved, when I gave all diligence to write unto you the common salvation, it was needful for me to write unto you and exhort you that you should earnestly contend for the faith which is once delivered unto the saints." Verse 4, "For there were certain men that crept in unawareness, who were before of old ordained to this condemnation, ungodly men, turning the grace of God unto lasciviousness, and denying the only Lord God and the Lord Jesus Christ." In verse 5, "I will therefore put you in remembrance, though you once knew this, how that the Lord, having saved the people out of the land of Egypt, afterward destroyed them that believed not." In verse 6, "And the angels which kept not their first estate, but left their own habitation, he hath reserved in everlasting chains under darkness into judgment of that great day." In verse 7, "Even as Sodom and Gomorrah and the cities about them, in like manner, giving themselves over to fornication and going after strange flesh."
Right.
Not only they was in fornication, they going after something funny.
All right.
Something God didn't ordain. You know, and that's the same thing this world is going today. Going after something God, it's not even natural.
Yeah.
Even animals know better than it, you know.
Yes.
And that's a shame of an animal kingdom know better. What's wrong with human beings? And like the other answers, I guess, stated, God gave us dominion over the animals, but the animals are smarter than some human beings.
All right.
That's the same. But this is what happens when mankind, you know, like Prophet forestated, how God found a certain amount of favor with America because allowed the Christian church and the Christian family to unite in America, but now America's turning their back on God. You got all these drugs, you got all this pornography, you got two men wanting to get in the bed together. You got all this alcohol, you got all this poison in America, you know? And then even trying to, we gotta know God before, who can be against you? Even the president, of the United States, you know? The Bible say God tore down kingdoms for their sake, you know? So the president, Hillary Clinton or whoever, you know, you better be careful when you attack God in this church, you know, because God will move, you know. Once God moves, you better get out the way, you know, because God, he's a powerful God, you know.
Yeah.
God is a loving God. Look at all the blessings he done did for the prophets. Look at our truth, you know. Maybe some of them ain't here, but they still blessed, though. God still got a chance, you know. So, you know, just like, you gotta love to faith, but it's far from my soul, you know.
Amen.
You know, I'm still blessed. Lord's willing to get the two full to keep right on going, you know. Mother Smith had a little something that she said, it, you know, and I told her, just put your faith in God. God's going to bring God. Look at real things, you know. Blessings to life, you know. We can't look at stuff from a natural standpoint. We have to look at, like I said, always in the spirit, you know. You know, we might not have everything we want, but we got everything we need. We got everything we need, you know. We're not lacking for nothing. We got food on the table, clothes on our back, and mainly we got the prophet and the word of God, you know. So be happy, you know. And I thank God, you know, for Shiloh, because this is a blessing, you know. I don't take Shiloh for granted. It is truly a blessing. Worse and worse, you know. Who knows, you know, 10 years, 20, even 20 years from now, should God tear, you know, the condition that the world might be in. But God got a rest in place for us, you know.
Amen.
We got somewhere to lay our head. We ain't got to worry about losing victory. You know, no one coming with a notice on the door telling you got 30 days to get your stuff out, you know. We ain't got to worry about that.
See,
that adversary children got that to worry about, because anything could come up. A sickness will come in, lay you off work for 6 months, a year, you know. I came in to work, and they said a guy used to travel on one of Heiston, so he passed away. Now I seen him, I guess, just a few months ago, riding around and everything fine, and boom, just like that, you know, dead and gone, you know what I mean? But that's how the Lord comes. The Bible say like a thief in the night, you know. Like a thief in the night. That's why you got to have your bags packed, you know. Heart made up and mind fixed, you know. Who knows, you know. Who knows, you know. You never know, you know. But I thank God, like I say, that when the afflictions come, true light rebuke them, you know. Cancer, diabetes, you know. Whatever might come out with a stroke, a heart attack, you know. It don't have no power over the Lord, you know. You gotta pray and prophesy, you know. Pray for us, you know. Always praying for us, you know. We can't take that for granted, you know. We cannot take that for granted, you
Amen.
Know. Just like Hezekiah, you know. Bible say he was sick unto death. But Hezekiah turned his face to the wall. So I ain't ready to die, you Lord. Know. It's something I got to do. The Lord turned that prophet right back around and told Hezekiah, I heard your prayer.
Lord.
That's the same with two nights. God hears our prayer. Trust me when I tell you. Because if he didn't, would none of us be in here right now. That's what I tell you. That he hate us. You know, hate the prophet, you know, hate us, you know. If he hate the prophet and we as children, he hate us. But nothing the adversary can do. You know, might try to look test and trial, see him try to take our children, but we're going to get them back. You ain't got no victory, you know. God got the victory. You certainly want to see God, so be happy, you know, be encouraged, you know, be strong in your faith, you know. Bible say be strong, you know. God can't use no weak soldier. Be strong, very strong, and very courageous, you know. So I thank God for God's truth, pray my strength in the Lord.
Nobody loves me, Lord. Nobody loves you. Can't make me holy.
Praise
God. Can't make me true. When I was in trouble. Oh, I want to share something out of Acts.
Amen.
17th chapter.
Thank you.
A few seconds here.
Just, amen.
Lord, just place on my heart.
Amen.
17th chapter, book of Acts. 30 and 31.
And the times of this ignorance God winked at, but now committed all men everywhere to.
So if President Obama is right, he has to repent.
Amen.
And I have not seen nowhere where he has repented of passing these laws and introducing all of these laws that make sodomy and lesbian behavior legal.
Amen.
He needs to repent.
That's right.
Read that again.
17:30. And the times of this ignorance God winked at, but now commanded all men.
Now, it is the time he winked at people's sins. But now he has commanded everybody to repent. Verse 31.
Because he hath appointed a day in the which he will judge the world in righteousness.
Judge the world in what?
In righteousness.
Right. All right. Amen. That's right.
A day coming which he's going to judge the world in righteousness.
Amen.
What is righteousness?
Amen.
It's what God said is righteousness.
Amen.
And they showed him saying he had accepted Jesus as Lord. And give me Matthew 7:21. Yeah, he just accepted him as Lord.
Not everyone that saith unto me, Lord, Lord, shall enter into the kingdom of
God. Did you hear that, President Obama? Not everyone that saith unto me, Lord, shall enter the kingdom of heaven.
Amen.
But what?
But he that doeth the will of my Father.
What is the will of the Father?
Amen.
Two men together? No. He said that's abomination.
That's right.
The word of the Father is to do what God said to
them.
Amen. Male and female made ye them.
Amen.
And nothing in between.
Amen.
Amen. So again, brothers and sisters, we're in the right church.
Amen.
And no matter how they try to blaspheme, twist the scripture, hide behind certain Bible texts out of context, God's word is true. He's going to judge everybody according to righteousness. You got to live it. Talk about it, but you got to live it. Thank God. Thank God for the Spirit. Thank God for everybody in the life. You made up your mind to stay here. Nobody made you stay here. You made up your mind yourself. Because you want to serve God.
Amen.
You want to show God how much you love him.
Mm-hmm.
Jesus said, if you love me, keep my commandments.
Right.
Oh, hallelujah. I thank God for you. One of the
Thank you so much for taking the time to hear the powerful word of truth from Prophet Bishop H. Walker. By way of special announcements, join Prophet Walker in True Life Pentecost Church every second Sunday of each month in Atlanta, Georgia at 957 Metropolitan Parkway at 4:30 p.m. Also join in with True Life every fourth Sunday of each month in Charlotte, North Carolina at 300 North Tryon Street, located at the Public Library of Charlotte. For further details, go to www.truelightpentecost.org and click on announcements for any current events. Thank you so much for supporting Prophet Walker and the True Light Ministry. Be encouraged and be blessed.
Blog Talk Radio.